outdoor workout here when we are in your neighborhood, Columbia. We are at Bare Hands CrossFit. Let's go ahead and talk to Mr. Scott Harris, owner of Bare Hands CrossFit. So what was I just doing just now? I wasn't playing just a game of catch by myself.
Yeah, no, that's actually a legendary CrossFit movement called a wall ball.
Mm-hmm. Love and, a wall yeah. ball.
And they're one of those things that people love to hate, so congrats.
I have to say, I'm a little winded.
Yeah.
What are all these good people doing down here?
All right, well, I guess what they have going on right now is a CrossFit extravaganza.
But, I see that,
yeah, we got all kinds of different movements going on here. If you want to kind of take a look through there, we got these guys with the barbells here in front are doing something called thrusters. Okay.
Dude,
we got pull-ups going on. We got kettlebell swings.
Man.
We have, let's see.
I heard a beep. Now. What was that beep that I heard?
The beep was the clock. And that's... something that's unique about CrossFit is that we track and measure every single workout.
Okay.
So I would say 99% of the time when we do our workouts, there's going to be a clock running because we want to know how fast you're able to do the workout in.
Mm-hmm.
Always focusing on movement quality,
yeah.
Okay? But we do keep track of time. That way, if we redo that workout at some point, then we'll have some kind of data to base off. Whether or not you're getting back into shape or into better shape.
Now, I do see some people here of all ages. Can you tell me how CrossFit can work for people? You know, of course, the older you are, the better you're at the exercise, right?
That's right, yeah. Everything gets better as you age, you know? But yeah, I mean, we'll have in one class, like actually the people here represent a pretty good swath of kind of who we see on a daily basis. We have everything from, you know, high school athletes to, you know, men and women in their 50s and 60s. So she used to have a 77-year-old. He had to move away, so we don't have him anymore. But what's kind of neat is we can have people from every age group and ability level kind of like in the same group at the same time. And because what happens when people start, they take an intro class,
okay?
And in this intro class, we learn how to do movements properly and learn why those movements are beneficial and that kind of stuff. It doesn't necessarily mean that everyone is gonna have the best form right away.
Right.
Somebody once told me this analogy, which I think works really well, is to go into a gym, across a gym, a gold gym, wherever, and expect perfect technique from everyone right away would be like going to a hospital and expecting everyone to be healthy.
Oh,
you know, so people are here to learn how to move better. People aren't, not everyone has perfect technique right off the bat, but our coaches try to make sure that we're striving for better movement at all times.
So can you tell me one more move, something that I might need to work on a little bit? What else you got?
Yeah, so we were talking earlier about how a lot of people can't do a pull-up. Okay?
I can't do a pull-up.
Yeah, and that's kind of one of those things like, we want people to be able to move their body weight around, right? And not everyone can do a pull-up, so we need to give you an exercise that works the same muscle groups and can develop your ability to possibly do a pull-up someday.
All right,
let's check it out.
Yeah, so I see that we have these kind of like rings over here. Is this
weird? Yep, these are just gymnastics rings.
Okay.
And we use these for all different reasons, but so this one is called a ring row.
Ring row.
Okay, so yep,
okay.
Both hands on,
okay.
Feet are gonna be pretty close to underneath the rings,
and
I wanna see your feet all the way together.
All the way together, whoa, all the way together.
All right,
okay.
Yep, and then your palms can face each other or you can roll them out this way, whichever you feel comfortable.
Let's do it this way.
And then we wanna make sure you have like a nice plank position on your
lower
body.
Nice plank position.
Yeah, you could even try dropping, I see your rib cage poking out. There we go, right there, that's better,
there
we go. Okay, and then whenever you move here, you're gonna kinda pull from back here.
There you go.
Yep, and the movement ends at the top when your chest breaks the line of the ring, so that's it right there.
Everybody, if you want to know how to do these properly, just go to Bare Hands CrossFit. There is 618 North Main Street, barehandscrossfit.com. We'll have links on the Fox 2 app. We are in your neighborhood, building our summer bodies in the fall and winter months here on the 9 a.m. show.
Let's go.